Good day and welcome to my video lectures about physics. In this video lecture, I will discuss about the definition of normal force. So let's start. So what is a normal force? Normal force is the force that surfaces exert to prevent solid objects from passing through each other. It is also a contact force. Normal force always acts perpendicular to the contact surface. Let's show the picture to illustrate it. Let's say the box has weight of 10 kilograms. Now the box will exert a downward weight force on the surface of the table. Every object with mass has a weight force on it. Due to the force of gravity, it is going to pull it towards the earth. Now the surface must be exerting an upward force on the box, and it is on the state of equilibrium. That means that the downward force, W, must be cancelled by an equal and opposite upward force. And this force is known as the normal force. Now let's say we have an inclined surface with the box rested on it. The normal force will always be perpendicular to the inclined surface. So it forms a right angle with the surface. Now, how can we increase or decrease the normal force? One way to increase the normal force is by applying another downward force. The reason is that the surface has to exert an upward force to support the weight of the box and also the additional applied downward force. Now, if you want to decrease the normal force, what you need to do is to lift up the box, and one way to lift the box is by attaching a rope to the box and applying an upward tension force. So by doing this, you reduce the stress that's on the surface of the table. Now let's talk about how can we calculate the normal force. Let's say we have a 10 kilograms box on a horizontal surface. Calculate the normal force that the surface exerts on the box. So the first thing to do is to draw a free body diagram. We have an upward normal force and a downward weight force. Because the box is in the state of equilibrium, the sum of all the forces in the y direction is equal to the sum of normal force and weight force. The normal force is positive because it is in the upward y direction, while the weight force is negative because it is in the downward y direction. According to Newton's second law, the sum of the forces is equal to the mass times the acceleration. Since the box is at rest, the acceleration is zero. The equation will become, therefore, normal force will be equal to weight force. Let's go to second situation and we use the same mass. We were going to apply a downward force of 200 newtons. Let's calculate the upward normal force. So the box is still at rest and it is in the state of equilibrium in the y direction. So the sum of the forces in the y direction is equal to zero because the acceleration is zero. So we have three forces in the y direction. And the sum of these forces is normal force minus weight force minus applied force. Therefore, the normal force is equal to 290.8 newtons. So, whenever you apply an additional downward force on the box, the normal force will be increased. In the same manner, when you apply a tension force of 50 newtons, the normal force will be decreased to 40.8 newtons. Now let's talk about the normal force in an inclined plane. So the formula to calculate the normal force is normal force is equal to weight force times cosine theta. So as the angle increases from 0 to 90 degrees, the normal force will decrease. Let's say we have the same mass and we apply a tension force of 200 newtons. So in this example, it indicates a negative 109.2 newtons of normal force. Now the question is it possible to have a negative normal force? If you have a negative normal force, what does it mean? It means that the box is no longer in contact with the horizontal surface, and so the net force in the y direction is no longer zero. It also means that we have an acceleration in the y direction. When the tension force exceeds the weight force, the object will now begin to move up, and it is no longer in contact with the surface. And once that happens, there is no normal force. Therefore, this equation only applies if the tension force is less than the weight force. Thank you.